We close with a different look at ocean life, how a group of citizen scientists use a dolphin graveyard to uncover how the majestic mammals live. The NewsHour's Teresa Carey traveled to North Carolina to bring us tonight's edition of a NewsHour Shares.
Keith Rittmaster, curator at the North Carolina Maritime Museum, leads 14 volunteers into the woods to a place he calls the Dolphin Graveyard.
Shovelers.
They plan to dig up the remains of a bottlenose dolphin named Mo. Rittmaster discovered Mo 3 decades ago during a photographic survey of dolphins in the wild. He takes photos of their dorsal fins. Each notch, scar, and blemish is a unique fingerprint that allows scientists to identify individual animals. Rittmaster has tracked dozens of dolphins this way. He spent years following Mo across his 100-mile habitat from Nag's Head to Cape Lookout.
This catalog contains one photo from every day that we had documented Mo from 1992 and ending before he died on February 27th. 2016.
The North Carolina Marine Mammal Stranding Network's Vicki Thayer was among the first on the scene the day Mo passed away.
So we arrived and examined the animal for a necropsy.
This necropsy, an animal autopsy, gives insight into how Mo died.
Mo had been entangled in some kind of fishing monofilament line, and so that was likely the cause of death.
Over 300,000 whales and dolphins die globally from entanglements each year. Like this dolphin, Rittmaster found in 2011.
It wasn't until we prepared the skull that we could tell that the bone actually had grown around that fishing line that was killing it.
Rittmaster's collection is one of the most thorough in the state. He has whale teeth, an ear bone from a baby dolphin, and even ribs from a humpback whale. But his prized artifacts are reconstructed skeletons, many of which are one of a kind. Thayer gathers autopsy information on each beached animal, then helps Rittmaster bury them in his dolphin cemetery. Once 2 years pass, he assembles a crew of volunteers to exhume the skeleton.
Look at that, there's a humerus.
Exhuming Mo presents a rare opportunity for understanding the animal's entire life and death. Scientists can use the teeth to determine age and the bones to understand some diseases.
For older animals, you can see that the bones are fused together more, and so that kind of tells you a lot about the animal, what stage of life it was when it passed away.
It takes 4 hours to exhume, catalog, and clean Mo's entire skeleton.
My hope is that what we're learning today can build and help animals in the future.
Even though it is a graveyard, there is an overall feeling of optimism.
If it weren't for stranded animals, we wouldn't know very much about them at all.
Mo's completed skeleton will take 2 years to assemble. It'll be on display at the North Carolina Aquarium, Jeanette's Pier, in Nag's Head in 2019. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Teresa Carey in Beaufort, North Carolina.